We're back in Shawnee, Kansas to give you an update on the Nieman Road Reconstruction Project. It's been a little over a year since our last episode covering Nieman Road, and the corridor has changed quite a bit. Here's a quick recap to bring you up to speed. BHC RHODES was selected by the City of Shawnee to identify alternatives for accommodating motorists, pedestrians, bicyclists, and other users of the existing Nieman Road corridor. After final reporting, BHC RHODES was then hired by the city to design the corridor project. We worked with the other consultants and partners to develop traffic engineering concepts of the new corridor to present to the stakeholders. Once the concept was decided, BHC RHODES moved into the final design phase. We completed a survey of Nieman Road, determined grading and layout, and then moved into construction and utility relocation. BHC RHODES construction inspection team has been on site managing the coordination and construction of the Nieman Road project. Here's a quick update of the progress. All utilities were cleared from the Nieman corridor and buried underground wherever possible. As part of the city's goal to improve walkability in the downtown area, a great emphasis was put on improving the curb, sidewalk, and ADA ramps along the Nieman Road corridor and adding a 10-foot wide trail. In addition to brand new sidewalks, the city also installed mid-block crosswalks that include lighting embedded in the pavement to enhance safety when pedestrians are crossing Nieman Road. Crews are wrapping up the intersection of Johnson Drive and Nieman Road. The intersection is open as crews are installing the remaining streetlights at Johnson Drive and Nieman. Two plazas with sitting and play areas will be located on both the east and west side of Nieman Road near Roger Road. Concrete pads are being finished so the new structures can be put into place. As crews work hard to put the finishing touches on all the new features along Nieman Road, please remember to pay attention to new pavement striping, occasional lane closures, and be sure to drive safely through construction zones.